Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My hair is straight for the first time in months. What do we think? I'm kind of digging it. Anyway, hi, if you're new, welcome. My name's Sam. I'm a professional hairstylist. In a couple weeks, I will be celebrating my 2-year anniversary of professionally doing hair. February 13th, 2018. Was the day that I graduated from beauty school. And I thought to celebrate, I would go back and look at some photos of hair that I did when I was in beauty school. I have my glass of wine here just in case. You guys know, or if you don't know, hi, welcome. I love to learn from my mistakes, reflect on past situations, and always try to grow and get better and just learn how I can become a better stylist, whether that's in my actual technical skills or with my communication with clients. And I try to always share that information with you guys as well, so we can all grow and get better together. All right, so we're gonna go all the way down to the bottom. So I'm just gonna go through and react to this hair, tell you the story behind some of these photos. First of all, I can't even believe when I started school how long my hair was. It was so dark and so long. That was like the longest and healthiest I think it had ever been. And then shortly after that, I chopped a good amount of it off and started going lighter. So I had this like golden blonde lob, and then I eventually went lighter and lighter. Oh, and then I had an undercut. I remember me and a bunch of girls in my class all decided to do that together. We shaved underneath and we all got different designs shaved in there. Good times. So the first photo that I have here is actually a color correction that I did on my classmate and friend Paige. I did a video with her last year, actually one of my salon vlogs. You guys may have seen that, where I did her hair. She had been blonde, but she wanted like a really grandma silvery gray kind of lavender color, and she had gotten her hair done by another girl at our school and she just didn't lighten her enough. She still had way too much warmth in her hair, and so you can see it was very uneven, very banded. So I remember I did this in class. I don't even think we were out on the floor taking clients yet, and she was just like so upset about her hair. So our teacher let us, at the end of the day, he was like, okay, if you guys get all your work done early and you have time, I'll let you do this in class. So I just remember I went through and I just went over all of the pieces that weren't light enough, that still had a lot of warmth to them, and I tried to just get her as light and as even as possible. And then I don't remember exactly what the silver color was, because she ended up throwing that on once she got home because we ran out of time, but I know it was Guy Tang, and it actually came out pretty damn good. I'm not even gonna lie, especially considering that I didn't know what the hell I was doing. The only thing I would do differently if I were doing it now is I would probably do a little bit of a shadow root to kind of like blend it into her natural root a little bit more, but I think it looks pretty good. Oh my God, this picture. Okay, this was the first client that I took once I got on the floor at school. Like my first stranger that I ever did anything on. And I remember I was terrified. And this woman was so, so sweet. I ended up doing her sister and her mom's hair a bunch of times after this. Yeah, her name was Amy. Oh my God, she was just so sweet. What she wanted was super simple. I didn't get a before picture, damn. But we only did a trim. In the caption I said, just cut about an inch off and added some face framing. So it wasn't anything dramatic, but I was so nervous to even just like touch a stranger and like shampoo them. It was very nerve-wracking, but she was very nice, very easygoing, and it turned out really good. She was really happy with it, even though it was super simple. My best advice to any of you guys who are currently in beauty school who haven't gone out onto the floor yet and are feeling really nervous about it, what you're feeling is totally normal. You just gotta do it. Like, you're never gonna get over that fear until you just force yourself to do it. And then after that, I remember I was feeling so good and I was like, ooh, this isn't so bad, I can do this. Your confidence will grow. You just gotta force yourself to just go for it. The next picture, I actually did this on, she was like a friend of a friend. So she had some old highlights and a few inches of regrowth, and she just wanted to bring the highlights up more. I felt like I didn't really know what I was doing as far as like highlighting. Like, I didn't have any particular pattern or technique. There was no like rhyme or reason really for what I did. I just kind of went for it. I don't know. So I don't remember like what foiling pattern I used. I think it looks pretty good. I think I did a good job with her toner and like with matching everything up. Everything looks nice and even. I will say though, this one picture from like on the one side of her head, you can see a little bit of a line. So I definitely could have blended the highlights a little bit better on that side of her head. The next picture is something that I did on my friend Aubrey. She was one of my roommates in college and we've stayed very close friends since. So she had been getting balayage done on her hair, but it was just very, very warm. And she wanted something that was more cool toned and she wanted more of like an ombre kind of look. So I'm pretty sure I just did foils and I just went through and just tried to blend everything up. And then I remember I did a color melt with different toners. So I went from a darker color up top to a lighter color on the ends. And I'm actually really happy with how this turned out. I remember in person it looking even way better than it does in the photos. I wish that I would have like smoothed her hair out a little bit more and like put a little bit more effort into styling it. And do you see that one piece? Like she is one of those people who's always flipping her hair. So she had flipped some of her hair back. And so there's like those two pieces that aren't supposed to be there that like mess up the blend. And I wish that I would have like taken more time to really make sure that it looked perfect before I took the photo. That's something that I've definitely improved on is my photography skills. Oh, the next picture is on one of my classmates, Sina. We did this like denim blue color on her. The color actually came out really nice. I don't remember if I did this haircut on her or if somebody else did it, but it definitely needs to be blended better in the back. If I were to fix it up now, I would just take a comb and some texturizing shears and just blend it and like thin it out, texturize it a little bit more. Her hair is very thick and it just looks very choppy in the back. Ooh, this next picture. Okay, so I remember this woman had came in and she wanted a perm originally. And her hair was pretty long. And we were talking about her hair history. And she said that her hair had been lightened. And she did a few different things with the color over the last couple of months. So my teacher advised me to do a test strand. So we cut a little piece of her hair out from underneath and we put it in the perm solution for a few minutes and it started to just completely like melt. So thank God we did that test strand, because could you imagine if I spent all that time rolling her hair up in perm rods, putting the solution on, and then her hair all just melted off? That could have been a very, very traumatizing moment. Like, I think at that point, I probably would have just been like, yep, nope, this is it for me. I'm done. I'm good. So, yeah, we showed her the test strand piece, and she was horrified, of course. But she was, like, really looking to do something, like, drastically different. And she had a very, like, funky, fun personality. So my teacher suggested, why don't we do a really fun haircut, like something with a lot of layers and volume and like a really dramatic angle, something asymmetrical. And she was loving it. So she was like, yeah, yeah, yeah. So I remember my teacher had to completely walk me through this entire haircut, like literally every cut that I did. I was like, Bennett, you need to stay by me this whole time, because this was the first time that I was doing a shorter haircut and the first time I was ever doing anything asymmetrical. So I was like, I need you to stay right by me because I don't want to mess this up. I'm so scared. I mean, it looks like a beauty school haircut to me now. Like, it definitely could be a lot cleaner. Even the way I styled it is not great. I don't even know what the hell I did. Cutting is something that I've definitely struggled with a little bit. I feel like color always came a little more naturally to me, but cutting was something that I had to really like work on improving, and I wasn't as comfortable with it. Which, by the way, if you guys feel the same way, you have to follow Chanel Mariano on Instagram. I went to one of her classes last year and it was a complete game changer for me. She breaks down cutting in a way that just makes it so simple and so easy to understand. And it's like, rather than trying to memorize a bunch of different kinds of haircuts, you just understand how to cut hair. So then any kind of cut you want to do, you just know how to do it without needing to memorize the steps. You know what I mean? She is amazing and super, super sweet too. what was I saying? And I think I probably would have added a little bit more layering and more graduation in the back if she was looking for more volume. And then I probably would have added some waves with my flat iron and then some kind of texturizing spray or something. It's a lot of hairspray to really like give it that oomph and that texture that she was looking for. This next picture is my friend Steph. She was another one of my classmates and she just had the perfect blonde hair. She naturally is really light. I wanna say she's like a level 8 naturally. And so sometime in school, she ended up going completely platinum. And then everybody got to kind of take turns like touching up her blonde, which was nice because it gave us an opportunity to play around with platinum blonde hair because that's such a popular thing that everybody wants. And so it was cool learning different toning techniques and how to really achieve like the perfect icy white blonde. The lighting in this photo isn't the greatest, so it kind of looks a little bit off and kind of like a weird bluish tone, but in person I remember it was really beautiful. Oh, Kelly! She was another one of my classmates and I actually worked with her. We assisted at the same salon while we were in school. She was the sweetest, but she had asked me to just clean up her haircut and she wanted to go darker. So she was starting out with this really light lavender color. And she was one of those people, like, she had this shaved head. She was like the coolest. She always had like amazing jewelry. She was covered in tattoos. And she just had this little tuft of hair on the top of her head and she was always doing it a different color. Like every week practically, she did a different color. And this day in particular, she wanted to go darker and she wanted to just add a pop of purple. So I remember the purple piece we left out, I probably just put it like in foil with some conditioner on it. And then the rest of her hair we had to fill, obviously, to get it that dark color so that it didn't turn muddy. And then just did a direct dye with that purple. The dark color I know was definitely Wella. I don't remember the formula. And then the purple was Pravana. I don't remember which color. We may have even mixed a few. The next photos, this one I don't love how it came out. So this lady was actually super sweet too. So she came in and you could see she had like some old highlights that were grown out and then a decent amount of roots that were grown out and a lot of gray. So we did a root retouch on her and then I added a little bit more balayage to bring up those lighter pieces and just create a little bit more of a blend and then toned her to kind of like a caramel color. I love the way that the color came out. I think the blend is awesome. The tone is beautiful, but we decided that she only wanted a partial balayage. So I only added the lighter pieces up top and then all in the back underneath, I left her natural dark color. And then after we did the color, I went in and added some long layers to her hair, which then made the color look weird because she had these lighter pieces on top and then the darker color just kind of like poked out underneath and it looked a little weird. It didn't blend nicely. So what I wish I had done was maybe do the haircut first or just kept in mind what cut I was going to be doing and then apply my color appropriately based on that. I specifically remember when I did this, I wasn't super happy with it. And I remember telling myself, next time you're adding layers to somebody's haircut and you're also doing color on them, remember this and don't let this happen again because it's not terrible, but I don't love it. Also, the way I styled it kind of sucked. I just blew it out and I feel like I should have done a little bit more with it. All right, so I think we're gonna wrap it up there. I don't want this video to get too long. Let me know if you guys would like to see a part two because I definitely have a lot more photos to go through. And let me know what you think about this type of video. Hopefully you find it helpful and kind of interesting to hear me reminisce and talk about my experiences and memories from beauty school. I think it's always fun to go back and look at your old work and see how much you've improved. But at the same time, you don't want to be too hard on yourself because we all have to start somewhere. So if you guys are in beauty school right now and you're struggling with anything, feeling nervous, feeling intimidated, uncomfortable. Don't worry about it. We've all been there. Just keep practicing, keep pushing yourself out of your comfort zone. Take every opportunity you can to learn as much as possible. And as time goes on, you will just keep getting better and better. So that's gonna be it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you'd like to see more videos from me, make sure you're subscribed and hit the bell notification so you don't miss any of my future uploads. And hopefully I will see you in my next video. Bye.